Hello everyone, welcome to R&H Academy channel. Before solving exercise 1.4, remember that rational numbers can be categorized into two categories. First, terminating decimal expansion, for example 2 by 5. Another, non-terminating and repeating decimal, example 10 by 3. Question number 1 says, without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or a non-terminating repeating decimal expansion. Just remember these three steps and you can solve all the parts of question number 1. So let's do it. So let's follow our steps. First step, find out the prime factors of 3125. So 5 is the only prime factor of 3125, and thus it is a terminating decimal expansion. So in exam, do not forget to write down 3125 has only 5 as prime, has only 5 as prime factor. Hence, 13 divided by 3125 is terminating. Second part is, so prime factors of 8. So 8 has only 2 as prime factor, and thus it's terminating decimal expansion. Third part is 64 divided by 455. So let's find out the prime factors of 455. Since 455 has prime factors other than 5, that is 7 or 13. Thus, it's not a terminating decimal expansion. Don't forget to write down 455 has prime factors other than 2 or 5. So, it's not a terminating decimal expansion. Fourth part is, follow the steps, find out the prime factors of 1600. Divisible by 2. Four hundred is again divisible by 2. 200 is divisible by 2. 100 is divisible by 2. And so is 50. Now 25 is divisible by 5. And 5 is divisible by 5. So we can see the prime factors of 1600 have only 2 and 5. And thus, 15 by 1600 is a terminating decimal expansion. And how do we write down? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means 2 raised to the power 6 multiply 5 raised to the power 2. Since 1600 has only 2 and 5 as prime factors, Hence, 1600, 15 divided by 1600 is a terminating decimal expansion. Fifth part is 29 divided by 343. If you remember the cube of 7, you know 343 is equal to 7 cube. But if you don't worry. Find out the prime factors of 343. 49 is divisible by 7 and 7 is a prime factor. And so what we can see, 343 is a factor of only 7, and thus it's not a terminating decimal expansion. How will you write down an exam? Two of five. You got it. Two of five. So, it's a terminating decimal expansion. It's not a terminating decimal expansion. Now you know how to solve these questions. So, pause this video. Try to solve the sixth, seventh part. And the meanwhile, I'll solve this part. It's not a terminating decimal expansion. The sixth part is 23 divided by 2 raised to the power 3 multiply 5 square. And since when we can see that denominator has only 2 and 5 as prime factors, so it's a terminating decimal expansion. And how are we going to write down? Denominator has only 2 and 5 as prime factors. It's a terminating decimal expansion. Seventh part is 129 divided by 2 raised to the power 5, 5 raised to the power 7, and 7 raised to the power 5. And we know that denominator has prime factors other than 2 and 5, that is 7. So it's not a terminating decimal expansion. Seventh part is pretty simple. Try to do it by yourself. It is 6 divided by 15. 15 can be expressed as 3 multiply 5. And 15 has prime factors other than 2 and 5, that is 5. So it's not a terminating decimal expansion. You got it. Ninth part is 35 divided by 50. And we know 50 is equal to 2 multiply 5 multiply 5. So denominator 50 has only 2 and 5 as prime factors. So it's a terminating decimal expansion. 10th part is 77 divided by 210. Now we know 210 is equal to 2 multiply 3 multiply 5 multiply 7. Try to find out the prime factors of 210 and verify whether I'm correct or not. Now since the prime factors of 210 are other than 2 and 5, so it's not a terminating decimal expansion. And this brings us to an end of question number 1. So if you like the video, do not forget to hit the like button. Leave your comments in the comment section. Share the video with your friends. And do not forget to subscribe to the channel. And do hit the bell icon to get the fastest notifications. Thank you.